Hello and welcome to a video in which I torture my CPU all in the name of experimentation and public education. Now the idea for this video came about when the motherboard of my current PC died and I had to send it in for warranty repairs. During this period of time in which my X570M Pro 4 was in Taiwan for RMA, I was issued a full-size ATX motherboard as a loan. And unfortunately, I didn't have a full-size ATX PC case lying around and I had to wind up using this open PC frame that you see behind of me. Now obviously, as you can tell, my motherboard is now back from RMA and I have it mounted on the frame so as to be able to do some tests to make sure that it is working perfectly fine. As I was doing the swap of processors between boards and, you know, I had to reapply thermal paste to replace the ancient thermal paste that had been on the processor since day one in which I built my PC, it got me thinking that it might be interesting to do a little experiment to see, you know, the performance differences and thermal differences, of course, if one were to apply and not apply thermal paste on the processor. Now, obviously, as enthusiasts, we all understand the importance of thermal paste, but I thought it might be interesting to do a little bit of an experiment to try and quantify these performance and thermal differences if one were to, say, skimp on using thermal paste. Let's get started. Now these are the specs of my PC for this test. Do note that I've replaced the stock thermal paste with some Arctic MX4. The ambient temperature of my surroundings is approximately 29 degrees Celsius with no air conditioning. The applications I'll be using for this experiment are Cinebench R23, the free version of DaVinci Resolve R17, and the FPS game Far Cry 5, where I'll be rendering a video in DaVinci Resolve and thereafter running Far Cry's built-in benchmark feature so as to simulate performance under real-life scenarios. We'll start first with performance and thermals with thermal paste applied. With Cinebench R23's multi-core test, my PC gets a score of 8,454, and an average temperature of 93 degrees Celsius, with the max value hitting a whopping 94 degrees Celsius, which is not a great result. I suspect the stock AMD Wraith cooler does leave a lot to be desired, and we do get a low of 79 degrees Celsius. Moving on to DaVinci Resolve 17, I rendered one of my recent YouTube videos, an iPhone unboxing feature, and it completed the render in 3 minutes and 29 seconds while achieving an average temperature of 91 degrees Celsius, a maximum temperature of 94 degrees Celsius, and a low of 79 degrees Celsius. During the render, the processor boosted to an average frequency of around 3.825 GHz. Onto the Far Cry 5 benchmark, temperatures come down to more sane levels where, during the benchmark, the Ryzen 5 3600 achieved an average temperature of 78 degrees Celsius, a high of 79 degrees Celsius, and a low of 77 degrees Celsius. And with those not so fantastic results in the bag, pun intended, let us now remove the thermal paste and get started with the exact same volley of tests. To remove thermal paste, I swear by Arctic Silver's Arctic Clean Thermal Material Remover, which does a pretty good job of cleaning both the CPU as well as heatsink contact surfaces. And with the thermal paste off, let's see what kinds of outcomes we're going to get in the three applications that were run earlier on. With the same Cinebench R23 multi-core test, we see that the average CPU temperature is now 94 degrees Celsius with a max of 95 degrees Celsius and a low of 84 degrees Celsius. Oh boy. In addition, you'll have noticed that the score has also dropped to 8218. When rendering the same video in DaVinci Resolve, the render took longer at 3 minutes and 36 seconds, and the average temperature achieved was 93 degrees Celsius with a max of, unsurprisingly, 95 degrees Celsius and a low of 76. During the render, I noticed that the processor boosted to a lower maximum clock speed of 3.74 GHz, which explains possibly the longer render time. Now with these toasty temperatures, I'm quite sure that the Ryzen 5 3600 is actively thermal throttling so as to prevent temperatures from going beyond the thermal limit of 95 degrees Celsius. On to Far Cry 5, running the built-in benchmark yields an average temperature of 80 degrees Celsius, a high of 81 degrees Celsius, and a low of 79 degrees Celsius. And with that, here's a summary of the performance as well as thermal differentials. It's worth noting that idle temperatures for both the thermal paste and no thermal paste scenarios were in the range of 57 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius in both instances. All in all, these tests prove what we already know, that thermal paste is important in any PC build and you should absolutely not skimp on it, as doing so could shorten the lifespan of your CPU and impair your PC's performance. I'm getting these toasty results with an open test bench configuration. Imagine how much worse things could get if I had my PC all assembled inside an enclosed PC case. Now, one thing that probably contributed to the poor thermal performances of both scenarios, that is, with and without thermal paste, could be due to the fact that I'm using the stock AMD Wraith cooler, which isn't the best by any means. If anything, at the end of this experiment, one thing I'll be doing for sure is to upgrade my HSF for my processor, and I'll be doing a video on that, so do stay tuned. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching, do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I hope to catch you guys around the next time.